Welcome children, today we will start new chapter in social science civics, that is chapter number 9, urban livelihood. Okay, in our previous session already we study about urban administration. In this chapter you saw a city is a much bigger than a village. Yes, in city area you saw many facilities were there. Already in our textbook they shown you one picture related to city area. Here you saw many activities were there, means people they are doing some job, some people they are doing job as well as some are opening their shop. They set up their shop on the road, as well as here you saw big mall is there, as well as government provide you the different facilities like water facility, hospitals were there, many school, colleges, universities were there. Government will provide you the different systems, means traffic follow. Here people generally follow the traffic rules also. So city is totally different from the village area. Here you saw industrial area is there, bus stand is there, railway stations are there. So in this way city is different from the village. A city has a crowded market, bus stand, railway station is there. So here if we talk about our India, there are more than 5000 towns and 27 big cities in India. Yes, big cities like if we talk about the metro cities of India like Chennai, Mumbai, then Delhi and Kolkata etc. have millions of people living and working here. So in this way we come to know about the city area. Generally people says that city never sleep. So here through this chapter we come to know about city area. Our first point is walking on the street, how people arrange their shops, they settle their shop near the pavement or on the street. So this is the story related to city area through which we come to know about the different activities of city area. This is a city where my cousin lives. I have been here a few times. It is a very big city. Once when I come here, my cousin took me around. Yes, we left the house early in the morning. As we turned the corner on the main street, we saw that it was already buzzing with different activities. The vegetable vendors, here you saw various vendors, they sell their products. The vegetable vendor was busy arranging tomatoes, carrot and cucumber in basket at her stall so that people could see what she had to sell. Next to her stall was a lovely colorful one that sold all kind of flowers. We bought a red rose and a yellow rose. On the pavement opposite we saw a person who is selling newspaper with a small crowd of people around me. Yes, definitely every morning you wanted to get news about our country or about our city, so you read newspaper. Everyone want to read the news. The buzzing vibe passed and there were auto rickshaws filled with school children. This is the activity you saw nearby your areas in city. Under a tree, a cobbler sat taking his tool and materials out of a small tin box. Next to him, roadside barber had begun his work. He already had a customer who wanted an early morning shave. Yes, generally when we visit city area, you saw small stalls were there. Some people they are selling newspaper, some have tea stall, some people they are selling juice or other goods product. So here in city area, many activities you observe there. You saw bus stand is there, you saw library is there. People are engaged in different kinds of activity. A little way down the road, a woman was pushing along a cart with all kind of plastic bottles, boxes, hairpin, etc. In it, while another person on a cycle trolley was carrying vegetable to sell to people in their houses. Yes, it is very difficult to survive in a city area because living in a city is a more difficult than a village. It's quite costly than a village. We came to a place where rickshaws were standing in a row waiting for customers. It's a rickshaw stand. We decided to take one to the market, which was about 2 kilometers down the road. Here also they give you the small story about a Bachchu Manji, who is a cycle rickshaw puller whose name is Bachchu Manji. So he expressed his views how he live or survive in a city area. I came from a village in Bihar where I work as a mason. My wife and 3 children live in a village area. We don't own land. They are the landless person. In the village, I did not get masonry work regularly, and that's why they face the shortage of money. So the income that I earned was not enough for our family and for the survival purpose. They migrate or move to the city area. After I reached this city, I bought an old cycle rickshaw and paid for it in installment. Yes, they take a loan and then he paid installment for it. This was many years ago. I come to the bus stop every morning. My path is fixed here and take the customer wherever they want to. I work till 8:30 in the evening. Yes. So he is doing his job very hard. So I take ride of 2-6 kilometers in the surrounding area. Each customer give me 5 to 10 rupees per trip, depending on the distance. According to the distance, he take money. When I am ill, I can't do this work. It is very difficult for this kind of person because they are very poor. They are based from very poor family, and it is very difficult to take a leave. So on those days, I don't earn anything. I hope you understand the situation when you get leave for the ill treatment. Okay, ill situation at that time, he can't join the work or he can't pull the rickshaw. He faced various difficulties in this time. I stay with my friend in a rented room. I also paid rent of this room. They work in a nearby factory. I earn between 80 to 100 rupees every day, but out of which I spend 50 to 60 rupees on my food and rent. He also paid installment of his rickshaw. The rest I save for my family, and I visit my village 2 or 3 times a year to see my family members. So he visited his village, and that time he also sent some money for his family members. Though my family survive on the money I send, my wife also earn from agricultural work that she gets once in a while. So in this way we come to know about Bachchu Manji, who pulled a cycle rickshaw, and his life. Already we study about Bachchu Manji. Like Bachchu Manji, you saw in a city area a large number of people in a city work on the street, like tea shop. You saw mobile shop is there. Some people, they are selling clothes. Some are selling sugar cane juice, etc. So here, in a survey of Ahmedabad, Ahmedabad city, it was found that around 12% of all the workers in the city were people. They are working on this street. Yes, because you know that living in a city is a very costly work, because people are they are spending rupees to pay their rent for food. So that's why it is very difficult to live in a city in compared to village area. So here they sometimes sell things or repair them or provide a service. For example, mobile repair shop were there. Different electronic goods they repair and they provide services. They work on their own. They are not employed by anyone, or therefore they have organized their own workshop or a own shop is there. They have to plan how much to purchase as well as where and how to sell and set up their shops. Their shops are usually temporary structure. They change their structure, their shop, place to place, to sell their product or provide service. Sometimes just some boards or paper spread over discarded box, or maybe a canvas sheet hung up on a few poles. And in this way they sell their product. They publicity through this kind of carts or canvas sheet. Through this they come to know, people come to know about the price, the actual price of goods, etc. They may also use their own carts or simply a plastic sheet spread on a pavement. Pavement means a footpath. They can be asked to dismantle their shops and at any time by the police. Yes, because it's an illegal shop. Wherever they wanted to set up their structure, and sometimes what happened, police were dismantle their shops. They have no security. There are certain parts of the city where these hawkers are not allowed to open or to enter their shop. For example, if we talk about bus stand, if we talk about railway station, this kind of people, they can't set up their shops here because it is not allowed for vendors and hawkers. Vendors sell their things that are often prepared at home by their family members, who purchase, clean, sort and make them ready to sell. For example, those who sell food or snack item on the street, they prepare most of this at home. For example, pani puri. You saw pani puri stall is there. So here you saw many example is given in our textbook. There are almost 1 crore street vendors in the country working in the urban area. Urban area means a city area. Street vending was still recently looked upon only as an obstruction to traffic and to people working. However, with the efforts of many organizations, it is now recognized as a general benefit and as a right of people to earn their livelihood. And that's why some organization help this kind of vendors. The government is thinking about modifying the law and ban the street vendors so that they have to a place to work, and that there is also a free flow of traffic and people. Hawker zone have been suggested for towns and a city. Many areas you saw hawker zone is there in specific day. For example, they allot specific place in a place, a specific area, and they arrange their stalls there. For example, you saw Ravivari or Friday market is there. It has also been suggested that mobile vendors should be allowed to move around freely. Hawkers need to be a part of committees that are set up to take this and their decisions related to them. Here this girl tell us about city area. Here she talk about in the marketplace, what she observe in a marketplace. When we reach the market, The shops were just beginning to open, but the place was already crowded with the people. Because of the festive season is there, there were rows and rows of shops selling sweets, toys, clothes, footwear, utensils, electronic goods, etc. In our marketplace, you saw a variety of things they sell to the people. There was a dentist clinic also at the end. My cousin had an appointment with the dentist. We went there first so that we would not miss our turn. And we had to wait for a while in the room before she was called inside. Yes, this is the waiting area. She has an appointment. The dentist examined her and asked her to come back the following day to get a cavity in her tooth filled. Okay, so that's why she treated for the tooth. My cousin was scared because she thought the process would be very painful and was upset that she had allowed her teeth to go bad. And that time she is afraid or she is scared for taking treatment from the doctor. From the dental clinic, she took me to the new garment showroom because I wanted to buy some ready-made clothes. Nowadays, generally people wanted to buy ready-made clothes due to the fashion. Nowadays it's a kind of fashion. People generally afford ready-made kinds of goods. The showroom had 3 floors. Each floor had a different type of cloth. We went to the 3rd floor where clothes for girls were kept. This is a kind of mall. In city area, you saw various malls were there. You saw different kinds of brand and products they sell to you. And in this way, it is very easy to get things from the mall in a very low cost price. Here, another example of Harpreet and Vandana. Both are the business women or the business persons who is selling different product to the customers. My father and uncle work in a small shop during festive time, and I, on Sunday, my mother and I help them in a shop. Yes, sometimes many family members during festive season, we also help to our parents. If we open our business, own business, we set up our own business, at that time other family members also help to our own business. I started working here only after I completed my college. Harpreet said about her experience. She told us, "We opened this showroom some years ago. I am a dress designer. Our business has changed now. This says people prefer to buy ready-made clothes rather than they have to stitch. The trend this says is for ready-made garment. You also need to attractive display for them." Yes, nowadays in many shops you saw ready-made garments were there. It is very easy to buy and wear it. For our showroom, we buy things from the different places, mean from the far away places. We buy most of the materials from the Mumbai, Ahmedabad, Ludhiana and the Tripura. These are the hubs of wholesale goods where they purchase bulk product. Okay, some materials also come from Noida and Gurgaon also, towns near Delhi. We get some dress items from foreign countries too. Yeah, nowadays you saw trend is there. Generally people wanted to buy from the malls, big shops. Okay, a fashionable western kinds of clothes. There are several things we need to do to run this showroom properly. We advertise in various newspaper, through the cinema theater, television and radio channels. Currently this building is rented, but soon we plan to buy it, even since this market has become the main market for the people living in the surrounding area or the surrounding apartment. Our apartment business has grown nowadays. So we have been able to buy a car and book a flat in this apartment or in this complex nearby to our shopping area. Like Harpreet and Vandana, there are many people who own shops in various markets of the city. In market area, you saw a variety of things they sold you. Yes, we are very much interested to visit this kind of places to buy various things. This shop may be a small or a large, they sell different things. Most business persons manage their own shop or business. They are not employed by anyone, but they do employ a number of other workers as supervisor or helpers. If you visit any restaurant or a hotel, at that time you saw one manager is there, then you saw gatekeeper is there, you saw many waiters, cook, many people, they are doing job. Okay, so here many helpers you saw there. These are the permanent shop that are given a license to do business by the municipal corporation. In a city area, first they take permission from the municipal corporation, means from the government. The corporation also decide on which day of the week the market has to remain closed. For example, the shop in the above market are closed on Wednesday. This market also have a small offices and shops. This provides services such as bank, courier service and other services, because they are the business person and they have the collection of rupees every day, and that's why government also provide them courier and bank service. So we will study about new point in the factory working area, means the industrial area. In city, you saw industrial area were there, where you saw different kinds of manufacturing units were there, different types of companies were there. They produce different goods for the public. They provide service as well as they produce many things like clothes, chemical things, footwear, etc. So here they give you the example. Through this story we come to know about factory working area. I want to have zari work done on my one of the dresses which I need for a special occasion. My cousin said that she knew Nirmala who worked in a garment factory. Now we get the knowledge about how people work in a garment area, garment factories. Nirmala, who is a neighbor of this girl, do zari work and embroidery. So we caught a bus and headed towards the factory area. The bus was really crowded. At every shop, more and more people got on and hardly anyone seems to get off, because they all went to go factory area. People were pushed others to make more space for themselves. My cousin guided me to corner so that we won't get a squash or a place to stand. I wondered how people travel this every day. As the bus entered the factory area, the people started getting off. We also got off soon at the crossing. What a relief that I was, because she can't suffer like this. They all now went to the factory area. They entered into the factory area. There were a large number of people sitting on railing on in a ground at the crossing. Why they are standing? Why they are sitting there? Because they are waiting for the person. This kind of person give you the services. Now in detail we get information. They seems to be awaiting for someone. Some group had people on scooter standing and talking with them. My cousin explained that this place was called as a labor chalk. In city area, generally in industrial area, you saw labor chalk is there. What is mean by labor chalk? This were a daily wage laborers who work as a helper or masons. They dig at construction site, lift loads and unload luggages, unload the truck in the marketplace. They dig pipeline and telephone cables and also build road for us. There are thousands of such casual workers in the city area. So that's why at labor shop, what you saw there? Daily wage workers who wait for their tools for people to come and take them for the daily work. Yeah, people paid them daily wages. So that's why you saw in a factory area this kind of labor shop were there. We enter the factory area to find it full of small workshop were there. There seems to be an endless rows of them. In one section, we saw people working in a small room. On sewing machines, where clothes were being stitched. One person operated one sewing machine. Clothes that had been stitched were stacked on one side of the room. And they arranged all the clothes in a pile. We locate Nirmala in the stitching unit. She was happy to meet my cousin and promised to get zari work done on my dress because she wanted to attend one occasion and that's why she came to here for the zari work. Nirmala worked as a tailor in an export garment unit. The factory where she worked makes summer clothes for the people who is living in a foreign area or a foreign countries like USA, UK, Germany and Netherlands. Workers like Nirmala have a very long hours in the month for December to April. Yes, they are doing their work for a long hour. A normal working day begin from the 9 a.m. and finish only by 10 p.m. Sometimes even later, she worked for 6 days a week. Continuously she worked for 6 days. And here, at times when the work need to be done urgently, she work on Sunday too. Nirmala is paid 80 a day for 8 hours and 40 rupees extra for working late night. By June, the work is over and the factory reduced its staff. Now, factory will reduce their staff and at that time, this kind of workers or laborers, they face in trouble. They face difficulty. How to survive? Nirmala will also be asked to leave for about 3 or 4 months in the year. There is no work for her and that's why company will leave her. Most workers like Nirmala are employed on what is known as, these are called as the casual basis workers. That is, they are required to come as and when the employers need them. They are employed when the employer gets large order or during certain seasons. At other time of the year, they have to find some other work, means they work in another factory. Jobs like Nirmala are not permanent. Generally we saw some people, they are doing government jobs. At that time they have the security of job. Government will provide them all the facilities like medical facility. Government will provide them quarters, means a house for living, school facility for children. So this kind of job is called as a government job or a secure job. But if you compare with a Nirmala, so Nirmala is doing a temporary job. If workers complain about their pay or working condition, they are asked to leave. There is no job security or protection if there is ill treatment. They are also expected to work for very long hours. For example, in the cloth mill units, the worker work only a day and night shift. with each shift lasting for 12 hours. Yes, they have a very long hours to do their job. One worker work on one machine for a 12 hours and then is replaced by another on the same machine for the next 12 hours. So this is a kind of job they are doing. They are facing lot of problem during they are doing a private job. They face many difficulties. Here they give you the another example of call center. Working in a call center is a new form of employment in the big cities. A call center is a centralized office that deal with a problem and question that the customers or consumer have regarding good and purchase and services like banking, ticket booking. Nowadays you saw online shopping is there, for example Flipkart, Amazon, they also provide you call centers, customer care number, and they solve your all problems in detail. Okay, now we study about in the office area. My auntie Sudha work as a marketing manager. She had asked us to reach her office before 5:30 p.m. We thought we would get late, so we took an auto rickshaw that managed to get up there just in a time. Her office was in an area surrounding by tall buildings. There were hundreds of people coming out. Some headed for a car park while other went towards the row of buses. My aunt is a marketing manager in a company which manufacture biscuits, different kinds of biscuits. The factory where the biscuits are made is outside the city in a industrial area. She supervised the work of 50 salesperson who travel to different parts of the city. They get order from the shopkeeper and collect payment from them. She has divided the city into 6 regions and once a week she meets the salesperson on each region. She checks their problems, reports and discuss problem and try to solve it. She has to plan the sales in the entire city and often had to work late and travel to different places. She gets a regular salary every month and is a permanent worker with the company. Now, if we talk about Nirmala, we compare her auntie with a Nirmala. So, Nirmala has a, she can't get permanent job. But here if we talk about her auntie, they get a permanent job. She can expect her job to continue for a long period of time. Being a permanent worker, she also gets another benefits such as saving for old age, means a PF facility, provident fund. Apart from her salary, is kept in a fund with the government. She will earn interest on their savings. When she retires from the job, she also get the benefit or the money and she can then live on that. She also get the benefit of holidays. She get off on Sunday and national holidays. She also get some days and annual leave also. She also get medical facilities for her family members. Her company pays the medical expenses up to a certain limit or certain amount for her and her family members. So these are the benefits we get from the permanent job. She get a medical leave also. If she fell ill and her salary is not cut, if she take this kind of medical leaves. There are many workers in the city who work in offices, who work in a factory area and a government departments, where they are employed as a regular and a permanent worker. They attend the same offices or factory regularly. Their work is clearly identified. They get a regular salaries from the company or from the government. Unlike casual worker, they will not be asked to leave if the factory does not have much work or they can't get order. At the end of the day, we got into my aunt's car exhausted, but it had been so much fun. And I thought how interesting that so many people do many or different things in the city area. There are probably never meet each other, but it is their work that tie them together and help to make up city life. So in this chapter, we study about city life, how people, they are working on a street, how people, they are survive for doing temporary jobs. Then we study about permanent job, means a factory area or a office area. Through this, we come to know about how people survive in a city and which kind of problems they face. In this way, we learn about city area or a urban area. I hope you understand this chapter. Thank you.